Welcome to Faithful Fathering's podcast. This is Rick Wertz, founder and president of Faithful Fathering, and have Mike Rosas, founder of Uprising Ministries, with us today. Welcome, Mike.
Thank you so much, Rick. Always honored to be a part of this podcast.
Well, happy Father's Day to you.
Oh, thank you. Happy Father's Day to you also.
Well, it's my favorite day and my favorite month, so yes. There you go. Would you say I'm in the fathering ministry, maybe?
Yes.
Well, I do want to make sure that Father's Day 2021, June 20th is a special day, and I commit personally as a faithful father to move forward and with a new perspective of coming out of this COVID time. I want to be very careful not to go back to the before COVID busyness, the craziness. You know, some of these things really settled down during COVID. A lot of things getting canceled. We had more family time, more a lot of homes had more spiritual discussion than they'd ever had. Yeah. One of the benefits of online sermons is that kids could ask questions real time, and you actually had spiritual discussion around this church service. Even you didn't have to tell your kids to sit down and be quiet. So that was always a good thing. But I do want to hear some of the things maybe you gleaned over this past year as a family, and because there's three dimensions. So when I asked Dad to take a Father's Day pledge, a faithful fathering Father's Day pledge, and the first step of that pledge is that you will prioritize your physical presence. And again, before COVID, that may have been a big challenge. During COVID, it may have been a given. And now with this new perspective coming out of COVID, how are you making some adjustments to make sure you don't just jump into the old normal?
You know, it's so easy, and I would say even tempting, to go back to normal. I consider COVID the great reset. And if there's something I learned about history is that if you don't learn from it, you repeat it. And so my heart, really being intentional with my wife and my children, is, hey, we're not going to fall back into the same traps of trying to maximize our schedule and erase the margin that is supposed to be in there. So we've become very intentional. I took my daughter to her first gymnastics class yesterday, and I was excited. I'm telling you, I'm going to be the best class mom. It was me and all the moms, and I was there screaming for my daughter. And you know, I have a crazy schedule. I have a busy schedule. But if I don't schedule the things that are most important, then in reality, my schedule has lost its value. And so if there's one thing I've learned, is to double down on those things that have the most value.
Well, as you know, I'm completely qualified and certified to give add-a-dads.
Yes.
So I give you an add-a-dad, Mike.
Thank you so much.
And you are emulating our Heavenly Father, because it's in John, the first chapter of John, where he says, you know, in the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God, He was with God in the beginning. And then verse 14 says, the Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us, you know. And my contention there is just as God prioritized His physical presence here by sending His Son, you know, men ought to be prioritizing their physical presence in the home, just to emulate God's example. He set the standard, and we're to be there. So having a new perspective on the value of time and the importance of investing that time, being available, being involved, being physically present, is a huge step. So add a dad, Mike. That's a good
so
step.
Much, I appreciate
how
that.
About how easy is it on the emotional front? You know, because the second pledge is to be engaged emotionally with your wife and kids. How are you seeing that? What were the benefits during COVID, and what are some of the challenges you're facing as we come out of COVID?
You know, I'm a athlete. I've been an athlete most of my life, and so I'm used to wearing my heart on my sleeve. So, you know, I had to really make sure that I'm communicating through my emotional engagements how much I love them, how much I care about them. So I try to make sure, and I try to touch my daughters and my son as much as possible, on the shoulder, tap on the head, kiss on the cheek. I want them to know that their dad is there physically and emotionally. And so, you know, we've taken time. You know, this one time my daughter, she played this song that I was not ready for, I'll be honest with you. And it's called King of the World or something along those lines. And it's basically a song about a daughter dancing with her daddy. And so so I said, baby, do you want to dance to the song? And so I held her, and we began to dance, and she began to weep in a way I'd never heard her weep before. And so I just began to speak life over her and tell her how her daddy loves her and her daddy's crazy about her. She's amazing. And she weeped. My wife looked at me like, what's going on? And I said, this was not expected nor manipulated. And, you know, that just reminded me of how my daughter, even though I try to on a daily basis, our children are so hungry for that emotional engagement. And so, you know, at the most random times, I'll just pick my daughter up and start doing the tango with her and just start having fun with her, because I want her to know not only does her daddy say he loves her, but he emotionally and physically does.
Mike, that's such a beautiful example, because it reminds us, you know, dad's always asked me, is it about quantity time or quality time? And I say, yes.
I love that.
But
answer.
As you just found out, you don't control the quality.
Yeah.
She does.
That's right.
And that's a huge deal. Well, I had a little bit different dance a few weeks ago, Mike. I had the daddy-daughter dance at my daughter's wedding.
No, I'm not ready
and,
for that.
She picked Butterfly Kisses as the song. So I had done well up to that point in time, but I lost it at that time. So the emotions were all over the sleeves, the shirt, they're all over the dance floor. Tears everywhere. So, but that emotional engagement is what binds us together as father and child. You know, that's the glue that keeps us together through some tough times. Possibly, we know we can always lean on each other, and Jesus knew that, because again, in Scripture, he said in John 14, he says, "If you love me, you will obey what I command, and I will ask the Father, and He will give you another Counselor to be with you forever, the Spirit of Truth." Because Jesus anticipated a lot of the emotional issues that His disciples were going to face. And that was long before all the cable news channels and the yes. cell phones and texting and Instagram and all the social media platforms and everything else. So that idea of engaging emotionally by sending the Holy Spirit was all about making sure His disciples remembered what He said. Yeah. And so your daughter's going to remember for a long time how important she is to you because of the way you hug her, the way you engage emotionally. And that will see her through some of those early loves lost, because I know she's going to frustrate a lot of young men. I've seen her, so she's going to be one of those that is going to frustrate a lot of not frustrate. She's going to disappoint a lot of young men, because she's not going to settle for anything short of what her dad's example was.
Thank you. So, I have a question for you, Rick. I have a 1-year-old son at home. How does that emotional engagement vary from daughter to son? Because I have two daughters that, thankfully, I have a lot of experience with, but I have a son that I'm barely figuring out, and he's barely figuring me out.
Sons need hugs, too. They need those hugs, and they need that time. And it may be a little bit different. You know, I think I have one friend that would always just grab his son's ear, and that was kind of their handshake, if you will. Just kind of, you know, whatever says, you know, what is always important to remember, that girls want to hear that they're beautiful, that you love them, that they belong to you. They're your child whom you love and whom you're well pleased with. But then they also want to know that they're beautiful inside and out, and that they're worth fighting for. You know, your son wants to hear, yes, you're my son, whom I love, with whom I'm well pleased, but he wants to know that he has what it takes to be a man.
Wow.
And so those are the things we have to realize as a dad. And so how you engage emotion with your son, I mean, you know, I would try to get my son to talk. You know, boys, you ask a lot of open-ended questions and you still get grunts, you know. daughters are going to be talking the whole time, probably, you know.
Yes.
But the challenge is to, you know, work on those times. You know, maybe you don't feed your son. You know, don't feed him until he says something. Right? do something like that to engage him. And but at the end of the day, it's the same thing, Mike. You put your hugs on him. My son is 32. We'll still put a hug on each other.
Yeah.
Put the hugs on him. Be present. You know, we would go on a 3-mile road trip for a baseball tournament. And we wouldn't speak a word.
Wow.
And then we might drive across town, and we're just talking the whole time. you know, it's just about time.
Yeah.
You just give them the time and they'll engage as they can. But always don't ever think that boys don't need hugs,
yeah,
because they do. But they also need probably a little more wrestling,
right,
a little throwing around, maybe a little, you know, just punching around a little bit. You know, yeah, those are the kinds of things you can do with boys to get them engaged.
So what you're saying is I have to show my daughters I would kill for them, and I have to show my son how to kill.
Well, that's one way to put it. That brings me to mention I've had a dear group of friends that have designed a 940 project, which is taking daughters and dads out on a deer lease, and that's where we do our father-daughter retreat.
Oh, wow.
And we do the same thing with sons. So with that, yes, we're learning to kill.
Yes.
But we're also teaching daughters.
Yes, I love it.
So anyway, something to keep an ear to the ground for down the road. The first piece of the pledge is prioritizing your physical presence. The second is being engaged emotionally. The third, of course, is leading spiritually by example. Now, this time in the home and maybe some of the online services, things changed spiritually as far as your your leadership in the home over the last year?
You know, I think what impacted me the most growing up, I have three brothers. By the grace of God, all four of us still serve him. And it was my parents, they would get us in the church every time the doors opened. But they would also, at home, at least once a week, we would have a service. And my father, who's not a pastor, would preach to us. He would have all four of his sons who have no musical talent. He would have us each sing a fast song and a slow song. And then he would read from the scriptures and he would at random places ask, what are the last three words I said, to make sure we were paying attention. And during this COVID time, you know, seeing the online services reminded me, I've wanted to do that and I've done it a handful of times, but I've not been consistent with it. So I actually got my wife and got my daughters before my son had arrived. And I said, hey, I want to apologize to you because I've tried to be the best spiritual example, but I may have not accomplished what I feel is most important in my life, what I could feel could be very important in your life. So we started having weekly services where I would preach and the girls would pick a song and we would all sing together. And it was some of our most valuable times. I trained our girls to learn scripture through movements. And so the girls are telling me 2 months later, look, Daddy, I still remember the verse. And I'm like, okay, at least I'm doing one thing right as a father. And so, but you know, it was COVID in the midst of this really, really tough time that brought me back to my roots and showed me what was most important.
Wow, what an example. And that, and now how are you carrying it on? Are you going to continue that tradition?
Oh, very, very much so. We actually set it in stone in our family calendar. There's no option around it.
Fantastic. Well, and you said something that's very important, that this isn't perfect. You don't have to be a Bible scholar. You don't even have to be a pastor. And you certainly aren't perfect. I mean, that's one thing. Your kids aren't teenagers yet, but every child as a teenager knows dad's not perfect.
Yes.
The younger they are, they still think we are. And that's really a beautiful time as well. But, you know, dads, you don't have to be perfect to lead spiritually by example. In
100%.
Fact, it's almost more of a testimony to when you stumble to say, my bad, I have fallen short of what you might have expected. But hey, you know what Jesus went to the cross for?
Yeah.
And then you get to talk about this transformational relationship with Jesus the Christ with your kids. And then you take a step forward in leading spiritually by example. So that's a beautiful example and leadership there, Mike. And
that's
powerful stuff. We get our kids thinking and talking about Scripture in the home. You know, I always say that we don't impress the devil by going to church 2 hours on a Sunday. He's got us the rest of the time. And what too many dads don't realize is that they're practicing a religion with the busyness Monday through Saturday, right? And unfortunately, that's the religion our kids are catching because that's what we're prioritizing. And there's nothing wrong with working hard, but it's important to let the kids know spiritually that's not where we're headed. We're working hard because that's part of the role as a man in the home. It's also just part of what our calling is, but it's all for the glory of God, who is the real priority,
right,
our heavenly Father over our home. So
yeah. I always say our kids listen to what we say, but they reproduce what they see. And so it's important that those two things line up for us to really have that resonating impact on our children.
Right. Yeah. The other way to say that is they catch what you've got. Yes. So that's well said. Well said. Well, that's the third piece. So we have your priority. I will prioritize, be intentional to continue prioritizing physical presence that may have been much more improved during COVID or maybe not, but we're going to continue to improve it. I will step forward with a new perspective for emotional engagement, especially at the dinner table, with a focus on the counselor or the Holy Spirit. And I will also continue the momentum by discussing either the pastor's sermon or a particular scripture passage, as you suggested. And so with that pledge, I say, as a faithful father, I pledge to prioritize my physical presence, be engaged emotionally, and lead spiritually by example. And Mike, this will be available as a PDF. I encourage all dads to go to faithfulfathering.org. Awesome. And click the Dad Talk button, and there will be a Dad Talk there for Father's Day.
All right, and dads, so you heard him. Faithfulfathering.org. Hit the Dad Talk button.
And on that Dad Talk button, you'll be able to download your own pledge. And then there's a place for you to sign it, and you can have your bride witness it for you, or maybe a battle buddy that might be a little bit harder on you than your bride is. Your bride will probably sweet talk you a little bit too much.
But, I know my bride's pretty hard on me sometimes.
So anyway, there's a lot of resources there also to pull off the website. Dads, I just challenge you to make Father's Day 2021 the best Father's Day yet. And particularly as we celebrate some of the ways God worked through our family over this past year.
I love it. Thanks so much, Rick.
Thank you, Mike. Always a blessing to have you here. And man, I just again guarantee you that as you focus on the Father and take the pledge to be a faithful father, you will honor your mother and father, and your kids will be, you'll bless the next generation. So guys, keep giving them heaven. Be the dad you're called to be. That's the dad the next generation needs. God bless. Godspeed.